شيطان الرجيم ورتل القرآن ترتيلا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Okay, welcome to the program At-Tartil with lesson 15. And inshallah ta'ala, we are going to learn a new rule based on Suratul Humaza. And in each surah, we learn and practice a new rule. And this time, we are going to learn a rule of Iqlab. Iqlab means changing. What is Iqlab? Technically, it means to change a letter with another letter. And there are certain places in the Holy Quran where we have to apply this Iqlab, this changing in pronunciation. In a flow of recitation, we do change the pronunciation of one letter to another letter. And Iqlab will take place if Noon Sakin or Tanween is followed by the letter Ba. Noon Sakin or Tanween, both pronunciation is the same. If they followed by the letter Ba, the second letter, then that Iqlab, that change take place. Noon Sakin or Tanween will change into Meem Sakin. Meem Sakin. Alright. Now, it could be that it will take place within two words, where one word is ending on Tanween or Noon Sakin, and the next word is starting with Ba. And it is quite possible, and there are many examples in the Holy Quran, that it takes place in one word. But you know that if it takes place in one word, then only Noon Sakin can come in between a word, because Tanween cannot come in between a word. It comes always at the end. All right. So now these are examples. Qawlan. Now Lam with Tanween and followed by this Ba. And a smaller Meem is inserted here just to remind you, just to remind the reader, to facilitate them in reading, in pronunciation, that you have to make a club here, you have to change this letter. And we find this example in many places in the Holy Quran, and some example have been taken in this one. Now these are the two words, and the next example involves only one word. It's one word, but a club will take place here. Like, for example, the second letter, Noon Sakin, followed by Ba. Now, this Noon Sakin will change to Meem Sakin. Okay? Ambihum. And the next one, Jannatin. This connected Ta is with Kasratain, with Tanween, followed by Ba. So, instead, T-I-N, Jannatin, T-I-N, it will change T-I-M, Jannatim Birabuwatin, but softly. Okay? So basically, Noon Sakin is changing into Ba, you know, very slightly. Okay, Tam Butu, again, example in one word. So, Qawlam Baliga أَمْبِئْهُمْ جَنَّةٍ بِرَبْوَةٍ أَرْ تَمْبُتُ without waqf. Okay, more examples here in four lines, and each line has three examples taken from the Holy Quran. Some examples have been highlighted to facilitate you to learn the rule and to practice. For example, in the here Zawjin, this Tanween, and followed by Ba. Remember, this Iqlab will only take place if the next letter is ba. After nun, sakin or tanween. In this case, tanween and next letter is ba. So zaujin without, you know, joining with the next word. But when we're joining, then zaujim bahij. Zaujim bahij. And again, this you know, all that one. So now I would ask you to recite one line, making sure that because there is no sign of meme, smaller meme is there, so you have to keep in mind. Okay, just starting from Hassan, please.
Zawjim bahij layyam bi alsinatihim غَمَّمْ بِغَمْ.
Okay, well done, mashallah. So, properly, غَمَّمْ بِغَمْ, yes, that meme, mushaddad, that meme with tashdeed has been properly manifested, and also waqf has been made, stop, that is good. Okay, next line, Diba Sahib.
آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ حَدِيثٍ بَعْدَهُ خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا.
Okay, جزاكم الله. Okay, next one.
أَمْبَأَكْ يَسْتَنْبِئُونَكْ مِنْ بَعْد.
Okay, next.
مِنْ بُيُوتِكُمْ.
Okay, only one word. Next word.
Sumbulat
fa'ambajasat.
Okay, good. Now there are more examples taken from the Holy Quran, and most of them have been from part 30, apart from the last one. Okay, now here these examples, and you are going to recite each one. All right. So Hassan, please try.
وَأَنْتَ حِلٌّ بِهَذَا الْبَلَدِ.
Okay, next one.
وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى.
كَلَّا لَئِنْ لَمْ يَنْتَحَ لَنَسْفًا بِالنَّاسِيَةِ.
Okay, try again, and you have to be vigilant, you know, about that one, if he does any mistakes.
Kalla la illam yantah la nasfa'am bin nasiyah.
Okay, now this time ayin is clear. Okay, that was last time not properly manifested. Now, again, next, Hassan, please.
فَدَمْدَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِذَنْبِهِمْ فَسَوَّاهَا.
Okay, well done. جزاكم الله.
بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ.
Okay, now you see the last one. The summun, bukmun, umjun. All three words carry tanween. But only one tanween will change to mim sakin. Okay, and you know the rule about that one. Okay, so I would ask you to recite the whole this part of the verse. Each one will be reciting on the this one last line. Okay, starting from Hassan.
Summun bukmun umyun fahum la yarji'un.
Okay.
صُمٌّ بُكْمٌ عُمْيٌ فَهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ.
صُمٌّ بُكْمٌ عُمْيٌ فَهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ.
Okay, good. Now this is Surah Al-Humasa, which we focused in the beginning, and we learned that rule, and that is in verse number 5. Okay, لَيُنْبَذَنَّ. Here noon changes into mim sakin, and we are going to practice the whole surah now.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
الذي جمع مالا وعدده.
الذي جمع مالا وعدده.
الذي جمع مالا وعدده.
الذي جمع مالا وعدده.
يحسب أن ماله أخلده.
يحسب أن ماله أخلده.
يحسب أن ماله أخلده.
يحسب أن ماله أخلده.
كلا لينبذن في الحطمة.
كلا لينبذن في الحطمة.
كلا لينبذن في الحطمة.
كلا لينبذن في الحطمة.
وما أدراك ما الحطمة.
وما أدراك ما الحطمة.
نار الله الموقدة.
نار الله الموقدة.
التي تطلع على الأفئدة.
التي تطلع على الأفئدة.
نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة.
نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة.
إنها عليهم مؤصدة.
إنها عليهم مؤصدة.
في عمد ممددة.
في عمد ممددة.
إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة.
إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة.
Okay, Jazakumullah. Now each one will be reciting the whole surah. Okay, and you, the other remaining two, will be giving me feedback. Okay, starting from.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويل لكل همزة لمزة الذي جمع مالا وعدده. يحسب أن ماله أخلده. كلا لينبذن في الحطمة. وما أدراك ما الحطمة. نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة. إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة.
Okay, Jazakumullah. Thanks very much. Okay. Diva sahab. Mashallah.
Very good.
Okay, well done. And Sham.
Yes, very good.
Good. Okay, Sham. Good. Now, this is your turn now.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويل لكل همزة لمزة الذي جمع مالا وعدده يحسب أن ماله أخلده كلا لينبذن في الهتمة وما أدراك ما الهتمة نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة.
Okay, جزاكم الله. Thanks very much. Okay, what's your feedback, sir?
Yes, good.
Good. Are you sure?
Yes.
I think the pronunciation of ha,
yes,
is a bit not very clear.
Where was, which was?
Hutama, verse number 5.
Okay. Yes, apart from, you know, he's doing on ha, on that's good. But another point which I noticed here in the last verse number 10, this fi. Now this fi, fa followed by ya, this is harful mad. Okay, letters, one of the letters of prolongation, alif, waw, ya, and ya is one of the letters of prolongation. Now, it should not be prolonged more than needed because there is no condition after that. You know, it is, this is simple prolongation. It is not a detached or attached prolongation, like, for example, mad al-munfasil. Okay, or mad al-muttasil. So, because after fi, ayn is coming. If this is one word, within one word, and after that hamza is coming, like ja'a, you know, that one, and also al-mad al-munfasil, detached prolongation, like for example, bima unzila, unzila. So at that time you can. Otherwise, where is the simple prolongation, the maximum time is 2 seconds. Okay? So apart from that one is excellent. MashaAllah, is getting better. Now, last, but not least, Diva sahab.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويل لكل همزة لمزة الذي جمع مالا وعدده يحسب أن ماله أخلده كلا لينبذن في الحطمة وما أدراك ما الحطمة نار الله المؤقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة.
Okay, Jazakumullah. Thanks very much. Excellent. Okay, what's your feedback?
In verse 7, I think, where it's mim and waw, which is a muqadda.
MashaAllah. I think I'm very happy. I'm very pleased that you picked that point, which I also noticed, because here on verse number 7, mu, and again here is mim, waw, mu. But the difference between this al-muqada and this musada, here is on waw, there is a hamza. and it demands a jerk, a soft jerk, which is not in this case in verse number 7, Al-Muqadah. So a jerk was made on the both. Okay, so we have to make only one, where is a waw with a hamza sign on that one. It's a little jerk. Okay, otherwise it is. You have picked the same one.
Yeah.
Now the time for assignment, and when the time for assignment means we are very much close to the conclusion of this lesson. So in this case, identify and practice iqlab examples in first five rukus of Surah Al-Baqarah. Chapter 2, okay, chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, the first five rukus, one quarter, the first quarter, first ruba, and you have to find, and you see that I've taken that example, Ambi'hum, from ruku 4, so you could find other examples as well. So, this is the time for the prayer. So, have you memorized that prayer?
No.
Now you have to. Okay? Because by this time, you should have memorized that beautiful prayer. That prayer can be done after the recitation of the Holy Quran, in sajda, in qiyam, wherever, because this prayer has been reported from the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you can do in prayer after prayer. Okay. Anyway, next time you are by next class, you memorize please this one.
Inshallah.
Okay. So with this we conclude our lesson 15, and inshallah until the next program, we will come with lesson 16. Until next program, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytan.